Mr. Gates. So we talked with the Democratic challenger just minutes ago. Now we meet the Republican. ABC4's Brittany Johnson is live with Dr. Brian Zender. He's running for re-election. Brittany?
That's right, Brian. Brian Zender is here with me now live. He is running for re-election in District 8. I don't want to waste anyone's time this morning, and let's get right to some of the important issues. Good morning. Thank you for being here.
Thank you, Brittany.
One of the hot topics in this midterm election is health care.
Indeed.
Tell me where you stand on that.
You know, everyone has to have access to basic health care. It's so important. It needs to be affordable. I'm a physician. I've been in the trenches for 28 years. I know firsthand how important it is that people have access to basic health care. And we've got an initiative on the ballot this year dealing with health care, which is the Medicaid expansion. So many years we've been trying to get more people access to health care through Medicaid expansion. And this year it may happen. The voters may decide that indeed we want to have Medicaid expansion so that we will have up to 150,000 new people have access to health care that they could not have before.
How does Medicaid expansion do that?
Medicaid expansion makes it possible so that money that we spend as taxpayers gets matched by the federal government in a 9-to-1 amount so that we'll have up to $800 million to spend for people that have access, that need access to care. Now, it does come at a cost to the Utah taxpayer. That's something we have to be aware of, and we don't know exactly how much that may cost long term. So we have to make sure we do our homework and make sure that if we do decide that we want to vote for it, that we understand the ramifications involved. But I am all about access, and I want to see people that I take care of every day be able to see their doctor when they need to.
Hey, so another hot topic on this midterm election ballot is Proposition 2. Explain that and where you stand on
that. Yes, Proposition 2, that's the medical cannabis. That's where people that have a particular medical condition have access to cannabis, whether it be the THC or the cannabidiol product. That's the question that's up for discussion. And what people are kind of uptight about is the fact, well, just isn't this is going to get you high? Well, it's not about getting you high, it's about getting you well. And so who better to have someone involved with that than a physician that understands the science behind medical cannabis? I do, and I'm the only doctor that we have in the Senate.
All right, so why should people vote for you? There's still a lot of people who need to cast their vote today. Why vote for you?
Well, it seems like every issue we're talking about that's on the initiatives that's being discussed this year, whether it be education, because our children are the future leaders of tomorrow, and I've had a lot of experience in education, whether it be healthcare, whether it be cannabis, whether it be gerrymandering, I've got experience in all of those things because I'm working there every day, day to day, in the trenches, taking care of people. And not only I'm the only long-distance trail runner in the Senate, I'm the kind of guy that goes the distance. I've been on 8,800 doorsteps since March. And so I work hard and I run hard, and I will do the work that's necessary for our district.
Gotcha. Last question here. We've got about 30 seconds. Where can people find you so they can read more about you and where you stand on all of the initiatives?
Very, very easy. www.votebrianz.com. I'm on Facebook, Senator Brian Zender, and I'm on Twitter at Doc Brian Z.
All right. And you already voted. Who did you vote for?
I already voted, and I think I voted for me.
All right. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. I appreciate your time. We're going to send it back to you guys in the studio. But don't leave. We will be back in our 6 o'clock hour with more candidates for your election morning coverage. But for now, reporting live from the Utah State Capitol, I'm Brittany Johnson, ABC4 News.